Are you looking to learn how to ace the interview for your cloud architect job? Well, then this video is for you. Please subscribe and hit the bell for free cloud computing training videos every Wednesday. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of Go Cloud Architects, and we're an organization dedicated to providing cloud computing education. So this video is about how to interview for that cloud architect role. And realistically speaking, it would help you when interviewing for any technical role. And the reason is there's always going to be some form of a technical interview, and we're going to teach you right now how to win on a technical interview almost every time. And if you can't win this time because there's just a knowledge gap, how to still leave a good relationship with that potential employer, and then what to do for the next technical interview. So the first thing that I'm going to tell you, and we're going to give you four steps to do, and the first step may sound obvious, but it's not, and it's not because I've interviewed thousands of people in my career, and I'd say 98% of them mess up on the first step, which is the honesty part. Then we're going to teach you how to control an interview so you can close it down on your terms. After that, we're going to teach you how to show up with what you know and what you need to know. And that's a very important topic in job interviews, and we'll talk about that later. And then we're going to talk about the right attitude. So let's begin with honesty. Now, I've interviewed thousands of people in my life, and when I get resumes, they almost look like an advertising agency put them together and put everything that would look great down. And then when you actually meet the person, they don't have any of the substance there. So first, honesty. And I can tell you, I can tell when someone's honest. And here's what I'm gonna suggest. You're gonna have a technical interview and they're gonna ask you what you've done. They're gonna ask you what you know. And my suggestion right now is to be totally honest. And if you're honest with this, you can control the interview. If I ask you something about a technology and you don't know, but you start talking for 3 to 5 minutes about nothing, which is typically what you have someone that thinks they can bluff their way to prove knowledge to you, you've already made up your mind about that person. And I can tell you one of the things that's really challenging to work with is someone that you don't find honest. So if someone asks you a question, say, I just don't know, but I know a lot about this. So basically what I want you to do is to be honest about what you don't know, because they're going to know anyway. And at least if they think you're honest, you've got a good shot. But then point them instantly to something that you know. Because if you show them something you know, the employer will know instantly that you have the ability to learn. So show off your strengths. But if there's a weakness and it's an obvious weakness, tell them. And that will save the interview in a lot of the cases, even if you don't know. So now what I'd like you to do is learn how to control the interview. And what I mean by this, if I ask you a technical question, let's say I were to ask you about high-performance computing in a cloud environment, and you know a lot about this because you've been designing high-performance, low-latency environments. If I ask you, what do you know about high-performance, and you start telling me about clustered placement groups, elastic fabric adapters, and things like that, and you can go into some depth real fast, do so. Provide evidence that you are an expert on that thing that they showed you. And you know what? Me as the employer will say, wow, this person really knows, and they proved to me to so much depth that they're technically competent, I'm probably not even going to ask them any more questions. And if I do ask them any more questions about another topic, which I probably won't because I'm satisfied, I know they can do the job right then and there. But if I do and the person doesn't know, they've already won me over in the first 2 minutes. So impressions are made fast and they stick. And that first impression means more than anything you can imagine, because it's going to be very hard to change someone's mind based on that first quarter second impression. So impress them up front. And then if you do something you don't know, again, go back to that honesty level. So one of the things that I'd say is most important for engineers, architects, but also in interviews, is to know what you know, but also know what you don't know. And don't put things on your resume that you don't know, because someone might question you on them. Put things down that you know, put them down explicitly, and be very clear about your area of expertise. I can tell you, I've been working in tech for 25 years, and when someone knows a lot about a small area, they're highly in demand. They're a specialist, and they're generally getting paid more than the people that know a little bit about a whole lot of things. But they're in demand, so be honest. Know what you know what you don't know. Now, if you have a job interview and it's something that you're weak on, brush up on it. Definitely brush up on it so that you can say, you know, I don't know a lot about it. I've been spending all my time on this for the last 10 years or 25 years. And then if they ask you a basic question, show some basic competency if you can, but don't lie, don't bluff, and don't abusify, where basically you just string a bunch of bad words together and make it complicated for the person to understand you. They know, and it's never going to work out. Now, the last part, and this is probably the most critical part, is about your attitude. Do you look energetic? I don't want to hire somebody that looks like they need a nap all the time. I want someone that looks motivated and hungry and wants to work. So the energy, just like, are you there? Do you want to work? And that enthusiasm about what you're doing. Do you have passion about the topic? If you have passion about it, even if you don't know now, you will in the future. I mean, it takes 10,000 hours minimum to be an expert on something, which is 5 years of working full time, or 2,000 hours, or a 40-hour week. So looking at it this way, I mean, it's going to take time. So that enthusiasm for what you're doing, the employer can figure out. And you can find an enthusiastic person when they walk in the room. Everybody feels that it raises their energy. So the next part of that enthusiasm is, can you energize others? When people come to you, do they feel better after they've interacted with you and more energetic and more passionate? If so, you're someone they want to hire, even if you know less, because if you can bring up the level of the team, anything can happen. And I can tell you a personal example. When I started in networking and I took my first job at a major internet service provider in 2000, I was preparing for the CCIE lab at the time. And there weren't many of us. In fact, when I passed the lab, I was like about the 6,000th guy to actually pass. So there weren't that many of them at the time. But people came to me for advice because I knew I was there. And not only did I teach them and I helped them and mentored them, which I loved doing, but they felt better when they left. And the next thing I realized, I had a cube full of engineers and they were constantly coming to me for advice. And as they were coming to me for my advice, they were learning more. You know what my employer noticed? My employer says to me one day, he says, I noticed the training. I know the education. I never asked you to do this, but you're doing it anyway. You're sharing your knowledge. Wow. So I love that. And then obviously that worked out incredibly well for my career. But it was they saw that I was energizing others. And the last part of the whole attitude, I'd say, are you focused? Do you run a task to completion? So if you've had 10 jobs in the last 5 years, it's not a good sign. Have a reason why that happened. Maybe and if it didn't happen, at least, you know, it's a weakness. And if they ask you, tell them what you've done to improve, to be better. But are you focused? Do you have the ability to focus on the task at hand, or on your interview, or you're playing with your phone, or you're jittery, or you're fidgety? Do you look like you're changing the topic, that where you can't look them in the eye and focus on the answers? So that's really what we're going to talk about. So to summarize, be honest, because we can tell when we interview people. Control the interview, though. Take control when you can. Show some level of competency, and show deep competency if you have it, where you have it, so that by then they might not even ask you about areas where you're weak. Know what you know and know what you don't, and know how to find answers to the things you don't know very quickly, and make sure they know that you learn how to research, but tell them that only if you can find answers quickly. So learn how to find answers to things that you don't know very quickly, and learn and know what you know, and do what you know, and be very energetic and motivated about the things that you do. And just bring out the best in others. Have a good attitude. Be positive. Raise the energy in the room and raise others' capabilities. And if you do that and the employer senses that, they're definitely going to want you on our team. So now you know how to win a technical interview and how to not expose your weaknesses as such weaknesses, but show your strengths, and doing it with honesty, dignity, and ethics. So please download our free AWS Certified Solution Architect Associate ebook. The link is in the description below. And every Monday we have free AWS mentoring, where anyone working anywhere in the world, completely free, working on their Certified Solution Architect Associate exam can come in and they can ask us any questions about any topic on the exam. We're not giving away exam questions, but if someone's confused, say the difference between a security group and a network ACL, we'll answer those things live. So when you're studying, we've got extra resources that are there. And thank you so much for watching this video. I look forward to seeing you in a new video next Wednesday.